You're not here to vote, are you?
No, sir, I'm going to the Cumming City Hall meeting. Thank you for asking and holding the door.
Thank you.
I hear a motion to come out of executive session. Second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. And I call meeting back to order. Again, I apologize for walking out on you for a few minutes in executive session to discuss pending litigation and property acquisitions. Very important that we get that. Item three is consideration adoption of the minutes of regular meeting on July 17th and executive session minutes of the same day. I hear motion. Second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Okay, item four, civic participation week. Have somebody here for civic participation who wants to accept the proclamation. Okay, let me read the proclamation and I'll ask you if you would accept it on the Haack civic participation week. Whereas the city of Cumming encourages all citizens to participate in their community and their government by observing the following four acts of citizenship. Volunteer time and talent to a worthy cause. Donate to a worthy cause. Communicate ideas. Stay informed. Vote your convictions with knowledge and purpose. Now therefore, let it be proclaimed that the week of September the 3rd through the 7th, 2012, be set aside as civic participation week in the city of Cumming, Georgia, in honor and appreciation of American democracy and the freedom it provides, and to encourage all citizens of the town of Cumming to take advantage of these freedoms that are made possible through the courageous spirit of the American people for a great pride. Now here to set my hand and cause the seal of the city of Cumming. This 21st day of August, 2012, signed by Mayor and Scoreboard Gravitt, attested city clerk Jeff Cumming. 21st of August, 2012. Ruth, if you would come up and accept these, counsel. Thank you, Ruth. Thank you very much for working today. Appreciate it. Okay, Okay, item A, recognition of Cumming Police Officer Benjamin Haack, commendation of field training, Chief Tate.
Good morning, members of the council. Officer Haack came to us, recent graduate of the Haack Police Academy, graduated last year. And he was hired by the official for us, and since he put in 480 hours of field training, he was all kind of
Okay, by virtue of the powers invested by me as mayor and the Cumming City Council, we want to present Benjamin Haack this certificate with successfully completed 480 hours of field training program and approved by the City of Cumming this 21st day of August 2012, and also say to Chief Tatum and to Officer Haack that our safety officers, our police, our firemen, all the military that don't get enough praise for the safety that they provide our citizens, not only our community, but our country. We appreciate the work you've done and do, and know the hardship sometimes that's involved in the work activities. So if you would come on up, Chief, you and Officer Haack, we'd like to present you with a certificate of appreciation.
Scoreboard is a Cumming City Park, the baseball softball fields we have there. service anymore. Both boards were placed there and have been used through an agreement with Coca-Cola some years ago. Coca-Cola this year has gotten out of its scoreboards. They're not providing them our service anymore. We've gotten as far as we can get with the two scoreboards we have there. In order to be able to provide scoreboard service with the teams that are going to be running and using the field for the remainder of the year, we are requesting that we be allowed to purchase two new scoreboards. We spec the scoreboards out and send out a total of four bids, or four requests for bids, and we received two back. The low bid was from Electromag Scoreboard Company, Rideshare Georgia, for $11,974. Second bid was from Netco Incorporated, Edwardsville, Illinois, $12,400.21. These are your basic 10-foot by 5-foot scoreboard, no frills attached, digits for the innings and the runs, and then just the dots with the ball slides and that. This is to service our needs and give us what we need without being extravagant and force agreement. We have worked with the local booster club that uses the fields at Dobbs Creek and at City Park. And they have agreed to split the cost of these two scoreboards with us. So while the cost of the two scoreboards would be around $12,000, City of Cumming will only be on the line for about $6,000 out of that. Donations from the local booster club. Our recommendation is we need to go with the low bid from Electromag Scoreboard Company in Blacksville for $11,974. We're expecting a 2 to 3 week construct or manufacture turnaround with the scoreboards, so we should be able to get the scoreboards up and going within month.
$11,974 was $12,000. We had our existing scoreboard, which has had upgraded over the years, but they were running at what, 1973, whatever park it was in, 73.
70s at some point in time.
So they lasted, what's the warranty on these?
5 years.
What? They serve.
Well, they have a service company that will perform the warranty work for the first 5 years. It won't get struck by lightning, it will be on the ground. But any manufacturing problems with it, they will take care of the 5 years.
I see you have the city's portion will be $5,987, and the others responsible from South Basketball Association, Western South Basketball Association. All the software and everything, controls and everything that would be needed with this, they won't be any extra expenses to come along and surprise us later.
Yes, sir. We are going with the wireless scoreboards, so it will be a brain. It's going to save a little bit on the installation for us, so we're not going to have to run new wire, hard wire out to the scoreboards. So it's a wireless system, everything's unlimited at the outset. This is a total cost of the scoreboards, the brains, and the installation on the two scoreboards. What's that? Yeah. Everything's digital.
Any questions? The recommendation of the board is $11,974 for the Electromag Scoreboard Company in Rideshare, Georgia. What's the pleasure of the board? Have a motion to have a second. Any discussion? Please signify by raising your right hand. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mayor.
Next item, Fairgrounds Department. We have a Flatbed truck request, Dave Horton.
Thank you, Mayor. Earlier in the year, we got a truck that was sold. So this is just to replace that. A flatbed truck is one coming. Several used vehicles, several several of those have been sold since the council. They've got a GM bid assistance program with municipalities and counties. And I've got a bid here for the one ton, which is 28,123.90. And that's happened to be so cheaper than we are ready for program in 2000.
Okay, is that the only bid, is this on the state contract program?
It's just like a state contract. It's actually, I said, our original one was on the state contract. The assistance from GM is the same.
I'm looking at the invoice cost here. It's $31,720. And they got the selling price of $24,000, so they discounted. This is the 2012 model.
Right. That's with 12 for bid.
And then they want another one, you make it, right? You don't buy it. That's what you
put the dollar out. It's not 12 for bid, don't you?
Right.
Right.
Oh, it's got a head.
Got a head, shows the bodies.
Bumper and everything, okay. So the total price is $28,123.90, what you request. Okay. And you said they have, according to notes here, they have another truck there, which was a used truck of 18,000 miles for 25,000.
25,000 for 07. 18,000 miles, 4x4 automatic.
That'd be a 5-year old truck, wouldn't have any warranty on the plan.
Is this truck automatic or is it
automatic? The truck that you requested or purchased is automatic? The $28,000 truck, it's not an automatic, is it? And you request an automatic?
I think we need to go with you. That's your best right play, like what I would like to
do. Okay. Your recommendation is this to go. Is that your recommendation, you from
this?
And then local scraper for $28,123.90. Is that your motion, Lucy, to go with purchase?
I make a motion and we buy the new truck.
We have a motion from Bush to purchase the new Chevrolet truck with the body, 12-foot flatbed body with a hitch and bumper for $28,123.90. Have a second from Brown. Any discussion? Please vote. See if I read the right hand. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Great.
Thank you. Okay, we have Cumming Police Department. Item 1, taxi cab license renewal request. Chief Payton.
No more. You received an application from Ulysses Arpita, Trochez, new business at Fairgrounds, taxi cab LLC. Question of public hearing conditions and certificate of public convenience reviews for hire. Background information company, The application is in compliance with the city coming due for highways. Our revenue is going on.
Okay, and you check his insurance and all everything, so it's paid his fee.
Yes, sir.
And it's very approved. I know taxi cab LLC.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and what's the pleasure of the board?
Mr. Mayor, thank you for recommending under your ordinance you require on this type of public hearing.
Oh, okay.
Because of taxis, the ordinance requires public hearings. You'll need to convey convenient ones just to see if anyone here would like to use the ordinance. There may not be anybody here, but all of this requires that. Excuse me, interrupt.
All right. I hear a motion to open for public hearing.
Yes, sir.
Second. Please sit the vote, signify by raising your right hand. Good afternoon, thank you very much. I have anyone here would like to speak in reference to tax account, their prison owes, tax account renewal license. Anyone speak for? Anyone might speak against? I hear motion to close public hearing. Second. Please, vote, signify by raising your right hand. Behind. Okay, we'll call the meeting back to order. And we can act on this tonight?
You can, you got a public hearing.
Yes, sir. Is your recommendation for approval?
Yes, sir.
Did I hear a motion from the board? A motion from John D. for approval. Item seven. Second, Quincy, in discussion. Please signify by raising your right hand. That one, thank you very much. Okay, we have a Forsyth County Board of Election request for additional space for voting. The voter coming precinct. I received this, I think yesterday, maybe, from Forsyth County Board of Commissioners, virtue of the request by the voters register. I'm of the opinion, and I think statistics will, the voting will bear me out, that we've had the SPOS election here, and we didn't have an issue. And we've had the primary election, and there wasn't an issue. We're having a runoff today, and obviously there's a low turnout, no issue. And we really haven't had a general election, so I'd like to recommend to the board that we postpone this for the November meeting until after the November general election and see if we've got a space issue. And if we do, we can correct it at that time. So, you know, I just feel like that we entered into an agreement with the county in reference to this to provide a location less than a year ago. And we haven't had a general election, so I think we probably need to have a general election before we really know or that we have enough space to facilitate the voters in this precinct or not. So my recommendation is to postpone this for the November election and be back on the calendar. Have a motion to round, I have a second. Second, John D., in discussion. For your own recommendation. Yeah, thank you very much. Okay, item E is Matthew's real estate contract ratification. I think we need a motion to approve the contract. Council, do you have anything that we need to add other than the purchase of Matthew's real estate?
What's better, this is a contract that approves the executive session for purchase of about 26.7 acres off of Kelman Road from Matthew's estate. The contract is, we're now in the process of getting the title problems cleaned up, and we would just need a motion to ratify the contract to the council find it to be in order to authorize you to sign the close documents. Thank you very much.
I have a motion that would authorize ratification of the sales contract and authorize the mayor to sign the necessary documents. So a motion, have a second. Discussion. This piece of property in particular is Kevin Mill Road, and it backs up to the Cumming Street Department property. This property will be used for the city, Cumming Street Department, for basically storage and things in the future. So it links to this property that gave the city. This property was formerly, part of the property was formerly a dump location for. Back in, I can remember the kid back in the 50s, it was all the, anything that was to be discarded, done away with, put in a big ravine type. So this is the property we're talking about. But since that time, and it was vacated by the county probably 20 years ago, 25 maybe, the property had grown up in trees. So the city will utilize this in the future for street department. So, any other discussion? I hear a motion. Second. I think we've already got that. All in favor, say time, the list they very same. Thank you very much. Item F, the Forsyth County Water Interim Agreement Proposal. First of all, over the last couple of years, the water proposals have been tossed around from the city to the county, the Facebook, the website, just about anybody that you want to talk to will talk about the water proposal. How maybe the city's getting ripped off, or how maybe the county's getting ripped off by the contract that expired May the 26th. But keep in mind that this contract had worked very well over the years. It was entered into in 1987, amended in 97. The county had never been out of water in that 25 years. City was able to facilitate a wastewater treatment plant, work with the county on that agreement within the contract. But May the 26th of this year, that contract expired. Prior to then, we were working to try to negotiate, come up with an agreement, and the county sent, on May the 23rd, the Board of Commissioners sent the city a one-page agreement to the water contract, to renew the water contract. And this agreement was basically a letter of intent, because the agreement that they sent over, or the proposal that was sent over, was followed up the next day by a letter: if you agree to this, it's got to come back before the Board of Commissioners for approval. So, anyway, this one page turned into a 14-page document from the county attorney. And we worked on that 14-page document, and we haven't been able to resolve the issues that are between the city and county on this. Now, as I said, this contract expired May the 26th of this year, after 25 years. And in this contract that expired, during that period of time, for the last 2 years of that contract, the city of Cumming was working on a watering upgrade of the intake in Lake Nydia to support the county's needs and also future needs for the city. During that period of time, in that contract, the city spent $17 million for the upgrade of that contract that was approved by the Corps of Engineers, by APD. Under the 25-year agreement, any improvements that were made for the benefit of the users, they had an obligation to pay a portion of that improvement. The city of Cumming billed Forsyth County, invoiced Forsyth County in February this year for $11,400,000 for their portion of that, and the city has not received payment. The city has been subsidizing Forsyth County through this intake by virtue of one line alone that services the county's raw water plant, and over $500,000 was put in. To date, the county has refused to pay. So, with that said, and with the county working under a contract and a permit from EPD, the county permit was 14 million gallons a day. We're not obligated under the permit because the contract expired to furnish the county that raw water. So I'm going to request and recommend to the board that as of October the 1st of this year, that we terminate the raw water portion of the county. And all the water that the county will receive, which will be all they'll need, we'll furnish all the water the county needs. We're not going to cut them out. It'll come through the treated water facility of the city of Cumming at $2.50 a thousand gallon beginning October the 1st. So I think that's fair, that's reasonable. This could have been avoided if the county wanted to stand up to the plate and let the city quit subsidizing and the 17,000 customers that the city has is about half the amount or less than half that the county has, and it's not right for those people to be subsidized. This is an enterprise system, and we have to make it stand afloat above water. We can't let the system lose money. So by virtue of agreeing to the contract that the county wanted, they wanted 30 years at 10 cents a thousand gallon, which is the cost, and the city can't do that over 30 years and subsidize it with their 17,000. So my recommendation is what I presented, and what's the pleasure of the board. It'll be starting October the 1st, it'll be $2.50 a thousand gallon for treated water. The raw water will be discontinued based on the fact that it's illegal now for the city maybe to be pumping water since the county don't have a contract with the city for that permit. Have a motion? Have a motion for Raff. Have a second? Second from John Day. In discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Right here. Anything else come from this board?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I would be like to take full action on the proposed interim agreement that the county sent over to you. We just didn't have a motion one way or the other.
Okay.
The
interim agreement that's requested by the county was that the city front sell water at the county $2.25 a thousand gallon for treated water, which they wanted to discontinue as quick as they got the permit for their treatment facility, and raw water at 10 cents a thousand gallon. Basically, it'd be 30 years of raw water at 10 cents a thousand gallon. So, my recommendation is to deny the request of that. So, what's the pleasure of the board? Motion from Rack. Second John Day. In discussion. Signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. I hear anything else come from this board? I hear motion be adjourned. All set. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Thank you for being here.
I'm going to go ahead and do that.